Welcome to Military Technology Channel.
Fifty years ago, the United States made history. A plane with a long nose, two engines, and orange wings took off from Edwards Air Force Base in California for its maiden flight. It was a huge success. Created by McDonnell Douglas, the F-15 Eagle, as the plane is called, will continue to change the face of air combat. Designed as a dedicated air superiority fighter, it has become one of the most successful fighters in the world. The majority of his kills were honed by the Israeli Air Force, which received the plane 4 years later and has used it ever since in combat missions across the Middle East. This was the first time a fourth-generation aircraft had arrived in the Middle East, and even before using it, pilots felt that Israel had created a new level of deterrence. Syria and Egypt now understand, just 3 years after the Yom Kippur War, that the next war will not look the same. Israel still maintains air superiority, but over the past year, the IAF has looked like it's been slipping. No fallout has yet been felt in the region, but if a decision is not taken soon, the well-known qualitative advantages that Israel lauds as necessary for its continued existence will suffer a crushing blow. While Israel does not disclose the size of its fleet, the IAF is reported to have around 600 aircraft. This includes fighter jets, transport aircraft, and helicopters. But because of budget cuts and the need to retire old planes that can no longer fly, the military has been downsizing over the past few years. For example, the IAF has retired a number of older F-16 models. Some of them were replaced by the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter, of which Israel now has 3 squadrons. The problem is that more planes will be retired in the near future, and if new planes are not ordered, the Air Force could find itself with a fleet consisting of only the F-35s, the F-16s, bought 102 in the mid-2000s, as well as a squadron of F-15s, known as the RAM, which have been flying for 25 years. Considering the threats facing Israel in the Middle East, from Hamas in Gaza to Hezbollah in Lebanon, and Iran's nuclear program, there is no doubt that the IDF needs to continue to maintain air superiority, which is ensured by having the largest, strongest, and most advanced force. Advanced Air Force in the Middle East. While the F-35 is considered one of the most advanced fighter jets in the world, the weapons that can be carried are limited as they must be stored in the internal ammunition compartment to maintain signatures such as low radar stealth. The F-15I, on the other hand, can carry more than 10 tons of different bombs hanging from its fuselage and wings. That amount of firepower gives one jet the ability to strike multiple targets in one surprise attack. Unfortunately, they have, and time is not on Israel's side. The challenge is getting bigger. Just listen to Hezbollah leader Sheikh Hassan Nasrallah's speech this week. But planes take years to build, and years more until they arrive and are operational. There's no such thing as ordering a plane today and getting it next week or even next year. The assembly line, like the one for the F-15EX, is currently building aircraft for the US Air Force and other customers. Israel cannot simply cross the line. The IAF needs to think 5 and 10 years ahead all the time. Generals like Barr think not only about the challenges he will face tomorrow or even next year, but also about the enemy and the types of threats his pilots will have to face in 2030 and beyond. Another advantage of the F-15 over the F-35 is that Israel will be able to install its own homemade systems on the aircraft, something that must be fought for every step of the way during the Adir configuration, the Israeli aircraft, F-35 version. Barr, the new commander of the IAF, is the one who needs to complete Israel's preparations for a possible attack on Iran's nuclear facilities. But first, he needed to strive for something else that could easily define his legacy, a well-organized procurement plan that would ensure Israel's qualitative prominence and air superiority for decades to come.